The founder and leader of Hamas, the terrorist organization, is Hassan Youssef. His son, his name is Mossab, Hassan Youssef. He wrote a book called Son of Hamas, which we have on our sites, and which I would strongly recommend. And we've worked most of the day to get him as a guest, and I want to thank him for being with us right now. Mossab Hassan Youssef, how are you, sir?
Hi, Mark. I'm good. Thank you for having me on your show.
Well, it is a pleasure to have you. You're an extremely brave young man. And I want to ask you several questions. Many people in the audience don't know about you. They don't know a lot about you. Some do. First of all, I want you to introduce yourself. Tell everybody who your father is and how you came to decide that you needed to break away from Hamas.
Oh, wow. So are you asking me to read
Take your
book?
Time. Oh, yeah, well, just summarize for us a little bit.
Sure. Well, my name is Mossab. I'm the oldest son of Sheikh Hassan Youssef. Sheikh Hassan Youssef is the top Hamas leader today in the West Bank territories, Palestinian territories. My father basically established the Hamas movement side by side with Ahmed Yassin and other Hamas leaders from the beginning. And at some point of my life when I was in prison, I discovered the brutality of my father's organization. Basically, they were torturing and killing Hamas, other Hamas members. So Hamas versus Hamas, Palestinian versus Palestinian. And I was shocked by that truth. And I came to see a different face of the organization. And since that point, I was afraid that one day Hamas achieves their goal of controlling the Palestinian territories, because I was afraid that Hamas is going to kill the Palestinians, first of all. And basically, I argued and I tried to debate everybody, but there was no way for me to continue in that area. I couldn't stand silent about suicide bombing attacks, because suicide bombers were killing Israelis, Palestinians, Americans, all type of people. And I worked together with Israeli intelligence not to serve one side against the other side, to serve humanity, to stop suicide bombing attacks. And we were thankfully successful at stopping dozens of suicide bombing attacks. And from my father's point of view, he considered that as a betrayal. And from the movement's point of view, they consider me as a traitor. For me, I am okay. If they want to accuse me, whatever they want to accuse me, I rise above their accusations. I rise above their idea of who I am or their perception. I think we did the right thing, and we'll continue to serve my fellow man. And we'll continue to transcend the cultural and the political barriers.
Now, Mossab, I'm talking to Mossab Hassan Youssef, the oldest son of the leader of Hamas. How old were you when you broke away and decided you were going to you're going to leave this?
Well, when I was arrested, at the age of 18. I spent 16 months in prison. That was the first time. And
okay, let me stop. Arrested by whom?
I was arrested by the Israelis. Mm-hmm. And I spent time in Israeli prison where Hamas, other Hamas prisoners were there. So now in prison, Hamas was suspicious of some collaborators who gave information to Israel. Most of those collaborators, or what Hamas thought that they were collaborators, they were innocent people. But Hamas was very angry, and they wanted to take revenge from anybody who was suspicious. So they tortured and they killed those people, even though they were innocent.
So other prisoners in the prison tortured and killed Hamas members?
Yes, Hamas prisoner versus other Hamas prisoner. Which, you know, again, brought me to question the real nature of my father's movement.
So you're 18 years old, and you get out of prison, and what do you do?
Well, when I was released from prison, the Israeli intelligence outreach to me. And they asked me with the name of humanity, you know, for humanitarian reasons to work and help them capture suicide bombers before they reach their targets. Now, suicide bombers, basically, they were targeting buses, schools, hospitals, universities, wherever, you know, they could reach. And hundreds of people were dying. You know, that was brutal, if you remember, about 10 to 15 years ago.
Oh, yes.
So during that time, you know, even though, you know, I was helping my father's worst enemy, you know, for me, I was not serving my enemy's agendas, you know, or this side's agendas and that side's agendas. You know, it was, if a suicide bomber reached their target, this meant the death of dozens of people. You know, that was like, I couldn't bear that anymore. And, you know, by the influence of the Christian teaching, let's say the Christ teaching, love your enemy, basically I felt the responsibility that instead of killing each other, we need to find a way, first of all, to stop the bloodshed. And with that inspiration and with the sense of responsibility, I agreed to work for the Israeli intelligence, and we continued working together till I left the region.
You were born a Muslim. Are you still a Muslim?
Well, today I consider myself a Christ conscience follower, if I can say. I don't belong to religion. I don't believe that religions can lead to heaven. I believe that it's a human conscience that will continue to evolve. And my inspiration is Christ conscience, to love our enemy, to love one another. You know, people hide behind the political and religious masks, and they keep smashing and killing each other on a daily basis. I am simply sick and tired of seeing the lies of political and religious groups. I think everybody needs to come to understand our responsibility, or otherwise we're going to destroy ourselves. Humanity will vanish if we continue to do this, taking advantage of state of chaos and confusion. People don't know what's going on in Gaza right now. You know, basically, we have to take a stand with humanity. Politics are not going to take us out of this in this circle of violence. We need true, evolved conscience.
Mossab, can I hold you over to the next segment, please?
Sure.
All right. Mossab Hassan Youssef, I have a heartbreak, we call it. Son of the Hamas founder and current leader. And we'll be back.
Constitutional lawyer you can see today for free. No appointment necessary. Just call him at 877-381-3811.
To Mossab Hassan Youssef, the eldest son of Hamas's founder and current leader, and a very brave man, in my opinion, I want to mention his documentary, which won major audience awards at the Sundance Film Festival. It's titled The Green Prince, and here's the key. It releases in selected theaters nationally in September. So we're really going to want to pay attention to this. This may have a real Oscar buzz to it, but more importantly, it's going to be extremely informative. The Green Prince, it comes out in September. I, for one, will see this, Mossab. Mossab, a couple of quick questions here. Hamas doesn't want peace with Israel under any circumstances, does it?
Yeah, well, Hamas is the misunderstanding about this movement, that most people think Hamas is a political party, or they think that Hamas is a national movement. Simply, Hamas does not have national agendas. Hamas has global religious ideological agendas that are very, very dangerous, not only against Israel, not only against the Middle East region. Their goal is to conquer the globe and build an Islamic State on every inch of our globe. Now, anybody who disagree, Hamas believes that they have the right and the authority to punish them by killing them. So basically, we're talking about an ideological movement that took advantage of a political cause where there is a huge state of confusion. Now they're using children and women as a shield, and basically they're provoking the situation that will serve their hidden agenda. This is what Hamas movement is.
Well, why don't the officials in the United States who are responsible for our protection and helping our allies, why don't they get it?
Well, again, you know, if you did not grow up in that environment and if you don't understand the nature of the movement, you know, for me, I was born in the heart of Hamas leadership. And I understand that we have enough intelligence, and I myself was part of the intelligence service for about 10 years. It's very hard sometimes to connect the dots. But today, I think more than any time in the past, the United States officials and decision makers, they need to take Hamas movement very, very seriously. Not because the United States only has interest in the Middle East, because Hamas is coming sooner or later, you know, and the United States of America, its people, its values, everything that this nation stands for is a target for Hamas movement. And Hamas movement, by the way, inspires all terrorist movements in the world, including Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda learned from Hamas. So basically, I think the war is not over. This is going to continue, and I think we need to be prepared and unify ourselves. Instead of mocking Israel now for doing the right thing, Israel in the Middle East is fighting on behalf of the free world. You know, if Hamas wins this war against Israel, the free world will pay the price.
Very, very well said. Let me ask you a couple of questions. Has there been a death warrant or anything put out on you by Hamas? And if Hamas were able to capture you, what would they do?
I don't know. I don't know. Let them do whatever they want to do. You know, we choose to live free. First of all, we are in a free country. Second, we are not doing anything wrong. Third, we are doing anything within our ability to improve the future of ourselves and humanity. Others are building, like Hamas, their biggest concern is to build a military to target the civilians, to target humanity, to kill any possibility for a human conscience to evolve. And basically, this is the type of enemy we're dealing with. And now we're not going to give them the gift of hiding anywhere. I think all of us, even though Hamas is a brutal enemy and Hezbollah and Al-Qaeda and name it, we choose to live free, and we are not afraid.
Has your father, since you left after and joined with the Israeli intelligence and now have left that too, has your father at any time since you left tried to reach you?
No, he didn't. Since the publishing of my book, he disowned me publicly, and since that moment, we have not spoken. Now, I hope that this will change at some point in the future. I hope that he will disconnect from Hamas movement. I hope that many people who support Hamas and follow the lead of Hamas will realize that they're going to self-destruction. And we will be able to communicate with them at some point and talk to them, just a human to a human.
What do you make of the idea that one of the proposals put on the table for a ceasefire was to give Hamas 40-some million dollars while the ceasefire is going on? I mean, isn't there massive corruption within the leadership of Hamas? Lots of this money doesn't get to the people.
You know, the matter here is not a matter of corruption or not. You know, submitting to Hamas is a terrorist organization, okay, by all means, because they use violence to achieve their political and religious agenda. And again, it's not a national or political party as we know other parties. Now, Hamas is willing to sacrifice as many Palestinians as it takes to advance their ideology. Every penny that is paid to sustain, strengthen Hamas' position as a governor of the Gaza Strip right now is a crime against humanity. Basically, any side that gives Hamas money right now, they tell them, take the money, build more weapons, and in the future, there's going to be a third and a fourth and a tenth Gaza war. Each time, we're going to witness the death of thousands of innocent children again and again and again, and we won't be able to do anything about it. Instead of going Hamas, giving Hamas money right now, and instead of being confused and not knowing what to do, as I'm talking now with due all respect to the American government. I know that I'm a guest in this country, and I love Barack Obama, but I think Obama needs to make a courageous decision. This is when leadership, true leadership, will come to the surface. Not submitting to Hamas because we have a few children dying in Gaza Strip or even hundreds of them. Hamas is responsible for the death of those children. And if Hamas continues to win this war against Israel because public is confused of the situation, there will be many other Gaza wars. This is the time to support Israel in its fight against this radical organization. This way, we will be supporting also the Palestinian people, the Palestinian children, by taking this cancer, uproot it out of the most populated region in the world, the Gaza Strip.
Yes, and you're right. There is this notion that Hamas somehow represents the Palestinian people and that Hamas has nothing but good intentions for the Palestinian people. But it terrorizes its own citizens, as you pointed out, correct?
Well, not only terrifies them.
Terrorizes them.
Or terrorize it. You know, Hamas movement took advantage of the conflict between the Palestinian Authority and Israel a few years ago. And they were building their military using the tunnels in secret. And they took over Gaza Strip and they surprised everybody with that takeover. Now, what if you look at some of the YouTube videos, what Hamas did during that time, they threw their rival party, Fatah movement, they threw them alive from the 20th floor, alive. You know, this is what they did to their rival party. That it does not agree with their political point of view. So they hit the Palestinian police officers with their RPGs. So basically what they're doing now against Israel, they already did it against their Palestinian rival organization. This will give you an idea that this organization, as a religious, ideological organization, they don't care about Palestine, they don't care about Palestinian children, or any political cause. All they care about to conquer. They want to have the superiority above all other fellow humans. They think that they are clean and everyone else is unclean. You know, I'm not saying this to make the movement look bad. This is, you know, their words coming out of their mouth. So practically, what we need to understand the real nature of this organization, and we all need to unify, Palestinians, Americans, Israelis. I would like to see the Palestinian Authority, instead of supporting Hamas right now, to work with Israel together against this radical, foreign, strange body that is sending Palestinians to death on daily basis.
Mm-hmm. Well, listen, we're out of time. I wish we could spend another hour with you. Maybe you'll come back, Mossab. We really appreciate it when your documentary comes out in September. You have an open invitation. You're now going to get scores of invitations as a result of appearing here. But really, we're very pleased to have you. You're very courageous. You're very honorable in what you're saying. I mean, it amazes me, given the indoctrination, given all the pressure, given all the threats and all the rest, that you were able to break free, because it's rare, isn't it?
Well, you know, thank God to all the amazing leaders who enlightened my journey. You know, Jesus Christ, Mahatma Gandhi, and many modern-day brave philosophers and thinkers and writers, you know, this is how we all help each other. We are all the same. You know, there is no all this like political boundaries that we put American and Middle Eastern and Israeli and Jewish and Arab. We are all the same, and we have to see through and understand the oneness of the human body and all unify against the enemy that is incarnated in movements like Hamas and Hezbollah and Al-Qaeda. You know, if we don't understand this unity and this oneness, you know, our future is really in danger.
Musab Hassan Youssef, son, oldest son of the founder, leader of Hamas. The book is Son of Hamas. We've linked to it on my social sites. The documentary coming out in September, which I intend to see, the title, The Green Prince. Thank you. We appreciate it, sir.
Thank you, Mark.
All right, take care. That was remarkable. I've been in this business not as long as some, but a long time. And I've interviewed many guests, many great guests, by the way. But that was particularly fascinating to me and illuminating to people, not so many in this audience, but to others who seem to think this is just about cutting a deal, having a ceasefire. Oh, it's just way over there. It's none of our business. This man is the eldest son of the terror leader of Hamas. And he made it clear time and time and time again in this interview, these people have more in mind than even the destruction of Israel and the Jews, that they're part of this whole caliphate movement with the Muslim Brotherhood and Al-Qaeda and ISIS and all the rest of them, Hezbollah, the regime in Iran. This is the battle, Hamas. And I remind you that here within our own country, this group CARE, this group CARE is the progeny of the Muslim Brotherhood and Hamas. And I welcome any one of their spokesmen to come on this program and debate me anytime, right here. I'll be right back.
Mark Levin.